This is squawroot, sometimes called bear cabbage. This is a very neat plant. It's an epiparasite. It used to be believed that it was parasitic, meaning that it would live off the roots of plants, mostly oaks, but some other kinds of trees as well. But then they find out it's not as simple as that. It actually is an epiparasite, and it is a mycorrhizal parasite. It actually feeds on the fungus that has to feed on, that has a symbiotic relationship with these different trees. So it actually is a three-way type of deal for this thing to survive. And lives underground. It doesn't need to produce its own chlorophyll or anything like that because, of course, it's living underground. It's taking food. It's not producing any. So it doesn't need to be green, doesn't need to have leaves, nothing like that. But there are no pollinators down there. So it has to come up once a year. This is its flowers. It's kind of hard to see, but the flowers are small, little, tiny things. And it produces those flowers. And if it gets visited by a pollinator, then what you end up happening is, of course, it reproduces, spreads the seeds, and hopefully the seeds will land into another place where they're in contact with this mycorrhizal fungi that can then give rise to another patch. The stems are long-standing. These are last year's, it looks like. Looks like we had a couple of them right there that broke off. Usually stay all winter long standing up, but somebody must stepped on them or something like that. But that's what's left over. The actual living part of the plant, the biggest, you know, the part that's most important is actually underground. But it does have to come up at least once a year, as I mentioned, just to be able to reproduce. Squawroot, okay, it was used all sorts of different kinds of things, particularly things having to do with squaws, pardon the way I'm expressing it. It was used for all sorts of women's issues, and thus, especially childbirth and menstrual problems and so forth, thus the name squawroot. The cabbage, the bear cabbage part of it, comes because it supposedly is a favorite in the springtime for bears to eat this stuff, and then it helps them clear their system, supposedly, including their, any fecal plug, any type of internal type of things that they can use to clear the system, so they can get up when they start feeding heavily in the spring. So again, squawroot, bear cabbage, a wonderful plant that lives in a menage a trois, a three-way, with a fungus and the tree roots, in order for it to produce to survive.